Okay, so welcome back to this spot. Okay, so there's no clear amount of new things closed in, so maybe I was wrong about that, but we went through the Tomb of Forgotten already. Next is going to be the Tomb of the Highborn. But hey, we already have one of the tomb keys, so why not use one? And hey, since I just went from the Tomb of the Forgotten, so let's use the key on the Highborn side, because people, it's always about the haves and the have-nots. Let's do some Robin Hood. And then you pay, let me guess, I pay the curse? What's going to happen?
It's like, you pay the ultimate price for coveting that which you do not have.
Oh. It's actually one that doesn't stand still. Okay, well, shuriken. Problem solved. And shuriken? Oh, they alternate. Okie dokie. That could be problematic, potentially. So what am I going to find around here? Any secrets? Not yet. As long as I'm careful, I'll be good. Oh, another shuriken. Neato. Should I just place it? I'll just place it here. Oh, more bullets. Oh, wait, I should check with the continue to check walls for secrets. Nope. Okay, more pellets. I have 114 bullets. Jesus Christ. That's the benefits of savings, kids. So if I step here, I'm set, right? So what can I put here? Do I have a leftover throwing weapon somewhere? There we go, throwing knife. Ta-da! So now we have a perfect plus sign of stepped on platforms. With no apparent reward for doing so, aside from some random bullets. Maybe I have to do it to both sides? I don't know. I figure just for fun, we might as well investigate what happens if I go down there, right? So let's quick save, really quick, so I don't die horribly. And I'll go ahead and just use the rope to climb down safely. What do we have here? Ooh, glowy crystal. I like glowy crystals. Any secrets? We have a glowy crystal back there. No apparent enemy yet. No mummies in the tombs. We have a torch. I'll just grab that torch. I'm gonna hold on to torches during this area, because it seems like they've already done one torch puzzle. Maybe they'll do more. I don't know. So I might as well just be ready for it. Is there no one down here? Is it just an empty mausoleum? Because, I mean, that makes sense. It is that type of area. Ooh, more throwing stars to use on pressure plates. Thank you, game. Not even having to use my rocks, which I've been hoarding. I've seriously been hoarding my rocks the entire game. That one's alive. Can I attack it? What if I shoot fire at it? Nope. Why is there a live mummy in that one? That's a little freaky, isn't it? Can I do anything to close it? Nope, that's just an exposed mummy. So far they've all been either open or closed, but they've never had a mummy in it. I don't know if that means I'm about to get attacked, or if it means nothing, but that's seriously all that seems to be here, which is weird. I don't see any evidence as to how I open this thing or get behind it. So maybe we'll have to check out the other side once I get the other key and see if that helps me out too. So that's one side dealt with. Now I need to do this other side. So let's go into the Tomb of the Highborn and see if how significantly different this might be. Is it going to be a totally different area? Is it going to be a mirror image? I don't know. You would expect the people building pyramids to just make two mirror image areas. Hey! Save, we have a healing crystal for all of the dangerous things that have been happening to me in this area. That healing crystal is really going to come through and save the day. I say with a hint of sarcasm, you know, because I'm a dick. What do we have? We have a thing. Looks like a maul. Some sort of mace. Probably a two-handed heavy mace. Which means it'd probably be best used by my minotaur, which probably means I won't use it because I already have the meteor hammer. Is it called a meteor hammer, right? Yeah, meteor hammer. I find it unlikely I'll be replacing the meteor hammer with anything else. We have some poison darts. Since I'll be keeping the hammer, that's a kind of pointless secret, but that won't stop me from trying to solve it anyway, just to be awesome and have the hub be jam-packed with a whole bunch of crazy treasure. So, we've now confirmed two areas are not mirror images of each other, which is surprising, because they're the insides of a pyramid. Did my light just wore off, didn't it? Bring that back. There we go. You'd expect the insides of a pyramid to be pretty symmetrical, but I guess not. Burial chambers. Oh, cool. So it's going to be full of mummies then. Let's blow some shit up. Hey guys. You want a hug? Let's hug the left wall. Ooh, a lever. That opens this place full of death. Neato. I'll check that out in a moment. But first, I'm going to come down here and die. Oh. Well, it was easier to find this thing than I thought. It's the Wand of Fear. Oh, it's a wand. Let's give it to my spellcaster then. Oh. It does 3 to 10 strength damage. That's weird. Cloud of Nightmares special attack. 30 energy, 2 concentration. Hold down attack button to use. This wand will strike fear into the hearts of your enemies. So, I guess it has a fear attack. I'll put that on my... I'm going to put that in my other hand in case I ever feel like I need that. That might be handy. It could be handy to have that attack. It doesn't have charges, does it? Nope, no charges. I can use that whenever I want. It goes like this. Oops, I'm using it wrong. Here we go, down here. Wand of Fear, go! That's really fucking unsettling, actually. It's like a Death Eater. Okay, a note. What's the note say to us? A gift for Hammond, the merchant. Gold was his only company. The Eternity welcomes him. Okay. So you must have really hated someone if you felt the need to just put spiteful shit out after they died. I'll just leave this here. That was the right note, right? Yep, gold was his only company. Hammond the merchant. Okay, yeah, that's... I doubt that's related to a puzzle. It's just lore for someone leaving an awful, horrifying puzzle. Yep, there's another one, too. A note. The note says... Let's check the item first real quick. It's a Moonblade, a light weapon. 10 to 31 plus dexterity. That's a cool-looking light weapon. But it requires 4 light weapon to even use. Symbolizing death and rebirth, this blade is held high... in high esteem by Zafi priests and priestesses, so it has Flurry of Slashes, which I think is the same attack that that one big sword I had before, so it attacks very rapidly, and has 10 to 31 plus dexterity, but it requires Light Weapons 4, which no one currently has. Although I think my tank is on the way, isn't he? Oh, he does have Light Weapons 4. Let's see. Let's find out if this is an upgrade then. Let's see. A gift for Newman the Warrior, his companion and their child, the Eternity welcomes them. So their entire family died. Okay. Let's see if this is an upgrade weapon or not. 10 to 31. 9 to 27. So it is an upgrade. Ta-da! Hey! Neato! And it has Flurry of Slashes. That sounds like fun. Is that the multiple attack one, right? Yep. So it's stronger than my previous weapon. It's a light weapon, so finally the fact that I've invested into light weapons is paying off instead of oh, that one required 3. I guess that was close too. But now I have a light weapons 4 weapon, so I'm keeping pace with my character. And I have a higher damage thing, so really all the items I'm using on my characters are actually starting to get pretty freaking cool, I think. But all that's left to do is pull this lever, I think. Oh, nope, we have this path down here to check out still. Another lever to the same room, it looks like. Keep an eye out for any potential secret buttons. Another lever that seems to go to the same room. I'm gonna keep avoiding these levers until I finish exploring the immediate... Another lever that seems to go to the same room. Is that one giant room? I don't know. I'm gonna pull this one, because it's on the end, and see if how it goes, I suppose. Worst case scenario is I die horribly, right? Ha ha ha. We have a mounted lantern. We have... this item, I believe it's the moss that you use to make bombs, which I've never done yet, but I should probably do at some point, since I have more than enough resources to make them with. How many do I have now, anyway? I have 14. So I could craft bombs 14 times, and I think I have a trait that lets it so I can... bomb expert. I get 3 bombs instead of 1. So 14 times 3 is, 12 plus 42. So 42 total bombs could be crafted by me right now, which is kind of fucking nuts, actually. I should probably get to that event. Well, at some point I'll get to it. Right now I don't care that much, because this is not a dangerous zone, so who cares if I have some more firearms? As far as I know, it's not a dangerous zone. Secret button opens something over there. Is there anything bad behind it? Not yet, at least. Finish taking a look around real quick. Nope. Okay. Let's be very ready to shoot at something if it comes through here. Secret found. Yes, I did. We have a necklace, the storm amulet, and Jesus, Mother Christ, oh my God. I clicked on the wrong spot. We have another lockpick. I guess I used one of them up, but still, I have such a surplus of lockpicks. Either this is supposed to happen, or I'm severely behind on finding... Maybe I'm just severely behind on finding chests. Come to think of it, maybe because I'm playing easier parts of the game right now, maybe I was supposed to find a bunch of lockpicks early in the game, and it wasn't supposed to be such a chore to find lockpicks for all the chests that I was encountering. But now, I've already played some hard zones and opened all the chests, so now all these lockpicks are amazing. Storm Amulet gives you willpower plus 2. I already had one of these, didn't I? And I didn't give it to anyone, because the only person that really needs willpower is this guy, and right now I'm just giving him bonus experience. Although, does he need bonus experience right now? I'm mixed. Because I could continually make my front guys stronger. What is this guy's necklace like? Wait. Immunity to poison, delays, perilous, petrifying. Oh, so he's just immune to all sorts of things? And this guy's immune to other things. Yeah, my tank's up front being immune to a bunch of stuff is good. This guy has the resist cold. Yeah, so this guy might as well just keep his experience necklace, so... I think I have... I want to say this is my second storm amulet that I'm probably not going to use. Or, if it's not this is my second storm amulet, then it's my second willpower amulet, I'm pretty sure. They could have called them different things. Anyone dangerous in here? Keep expecting someone to be in here. Which is not entirely realistic, because they are tombs, but I guess some of them are also walking up. Getting up and walking around, too. Really? An entirely empty chamber. Is that so? Yeah. I see no buttons of any kind around here. Okay, continuing forward. Next lever. Is this the last one? It is. Hopefully something's in here. Lever. Hello. Ooh. We have a big potion. A greater healing potion. And some bread. Okie dokie. Is very reminiscent of Egyptian remains and the way that they keep things around and they pledge things to the dead. This is definitely fitting the whole tomb thing. The question is, what do I do? Let's go back up here. Did I have a door I could open? I don't remember now. You're just closed. So... I have a dead end in every direction, so what am I missing here? Oh, these are clues, aren't they? Okay. Let's see. Warrior, his companion, and their child. Moonblade. No, Newman the Warrior. I don't know what to make of that one. But this one says... He's a merchant, and gold was his only company. What if I give him gold? Do I have a gold thing in my inventory? Not necessarily. Oh. Maybe this serpent staff. Okay. So maybe I'm supposed to put... I assume I'm supposed to put specific things on these two spots, right? So... Give for Newman the warrior, his companion and their child, the Eternity welcomes them. Huh, he's a warrior. So did I put a weapon there? Some weapons down? That's not doing it? What if I just use the horn? Let's just try using the horn, I guess. Nope, I'm just a crazy stupid person. Okay. That's not solving my problems at all. So I'm on the wrong track here. So I'm gonna have to figure out how to proceed. I'm gonna go ahead and stop recording for a moment. And we'll see... If I can figure out what to do next, because I'm pretty sure... Yeah, I don't have any remaining paths to check. They're all dead ends. Oh, wait, no. Wait. Was I able to just open... I genuinely forgot. I might be being really stupid right here. Checkpoint, I guess. Why not? I totally forgot about in here. Oh, running out of light sources. That's really unsettling to watch the darkness just come crawling in. Was I able to just open this one? No. Okay, not this one either. Yeah. Okay, so I'll see you guys in a bit when I figure out what the hell I'm doing here. Because we have two doors I don't know how to open, and a whole third door I don't even know how to reach so far. This is... Huh. Okay. Oh hey, the sarcophagus in the first room has another note on it. Let's see what that one says. Here rests Tehep the Architect, his companion and their two loyal servants. The Eternity welcomes them. Oh, wait a minute. There's four different cells here. And there's gifts for them, but they weren't at their cells. Maybe if I find... Let's see. Maybe if I find cells that match the descriptions... His only companion was his gold. Is this it? He doesn't have gold here, though. Did I pick up the gold and forget? Because, I mean... I did loot these rooms, which could affect things poorly. What's in here? There's no note. There's someone who had a companion and a child, so there should be one that has three sarcophagi in it, right? We have three sarcophagi in here. Which could be the companion and the child. And the gift for him was this. The blade. I guess I have to put this dagger back in place. I'm gonna be disappointed if I put these in place and it's like, alright, you lose these forever now. Okay, his only companion was his gold. So let's go to the only one that has only one in them, I guess, and we'll give him the fear wand. Because that was the gift for that guy. And hopefully the gates will be open now? That seems like it's the puzzle here, right? Is to take the gifts to the rightful owners? Oh my god, I am a fucking genius and I'm being attacked by snakes. My reward for my intelligence is that I get murdered. Goody. So this one's open. Is the other one open? It looks closed. Yeah, it looks closed. Okay, so just this one's open. That's fine. At least I made some sort of progress. And I figured out the clue. Coolio. That's what I get for dismissing some notes by thinking that they're not related to a puzzle. They're totally related to a puzzle. I guess the, since I put the items out in the open too, they're just laying on top of sarcophagi. When I finish this area, I can just go back and pick them up, which is good because they seemed like I put both of them on my characters immediately. So as you can imagine, I am under the impression that they may be useful at some point. Oh, here's where we're opening up. Who's in here? Anyone here to murder me? So this is the this is the room to the right of that other room. What's this button do? Oh my god, more snakes. Oh god. Okay. No, it's cool. It's what I was hoping would happen. Fucking flurry of fireballs, mother- Oh my god, I fucked up so bad at this. There we go. That's better. Oh. Did he die? Oh, he wasn't dead. But he will be in a moment. Ta-da! It's funny, because you don't exist anymore. Oh, he doesn't have any more room for food. Fuck it, the other guy will carry food. No one goes hungry in my crew. Oh, hey. Surprise, friend. Ow. You made me fireball myself. I don't appreciate that. No! He disabled the swinging arm of my guy that deals all the damage. He will pay severely for his trespass into my organs, because he's, like, giving me poison and shit. Oh, this goes so much slower with him injured. This is a bummer. I'm so disappointed right now. Where are you going? Fucking die already. Please die? There we go. So polite. Okay. Really? You damaged my hand? Yep, hand injury. Cannot use weapon. The good news is there's a healing crystal. Yep, just outside. So I'll just go back to that in a moment, but let's see what I found. So, my reward is another lockpick. Now I have 5 lockpicks. I am okay with that. We have a mural. It has a sailing mural. Possibly... Oh, it's probably a mural about this island. Let's go ahead and mark this. Sailing to island mural. I'm being attacked by a snake right now. Hello, snake. Going to very slowly murder you. Die to the snake. Death to the snake. Death to the snake. More death to the snake? You piece of shit? Sneaking up on me while I'm writing on my map? Very snake-like of you, to be honest. So I'm not entirely surprised. Frankly, that's what society expects of you. Maybe society's the real monster. Mirror gauntlets. Don't know what those do. And another note. Let's find out. Mirror gauntlets, a gift for Burel the Hedonist. His bloated remains needed 6 vessels. The Eternity welcomes him. Okay, let's keep these together, because I might need this clue. So mirror gauntlets give you 8 protection and 5 resist all. And they require light armor proficiency. Resist all. So they must go with that shield I had. My Minotaur had a shield that matched the mirror. He has mirror chest piece right now. Yep, 8 protection, 5 resist all. You'll see this character's wearing a really weird amalgamation of armor. He has a mirror chest piece because I don't currently have a better chest piece on me. I think I had a full plate chest piece somewhere. Oh, I'm still wearing it on this character because I haven't found crystal or meteor chest piece. That's why. So once that moves over, this guy will be wearing full plate. He's wearing full plate pants. He's wearing a heavy armor. He's wearing a really heavy shield too. Oh, it didn't even require heavy armor. Why did I wait? Okay. But I'm still wearing the bear skull, the bear stuff in general, because that gives you 4 strength. I might wear full bear equipment if I can find them all. But anyway, we need to find someone who's really fat, apparently. His blooded remains needed 6 vessels. The Eternity welcomes him. Okay. So we need to find some kind of fat person cell. Maybe if I review the other ones. First of all, I want to go back just because I want to heal, so let's do that first. But I may be able to find... Go quick, heal real quick. There we go. So what do we know about these things? So we have one cell here. It has 4 vessels in it, and it has a note saying whose it is. So we probably don't need to identify this one. Unless someone was an asshole and swapped the notes. This one is... Yep, that's the merchant. Already gave him his thing. This is the... We haven't given this guy anything. So that could be it. But it doesn't seem likely. And this is the family. Okay, so his bloated remains needed 6 vessels. Gift for the hedonist. His bloated remains needed 6 vessels. Okay. Was there pots in here? No? So 6 vessels, I believe, means, because in ancient Egypt, culture, they would take your organs out and put them in jars. So I believe this means that we're looking for a fat guy, he was a sinner of some sort, and, his remains are in a chamber that has 6 jars in it, I believe. So we just need to keep going until I find something that resembles that, I suppose. In the meantime, we'll just keep exploring and murdering. I saw that snake. You're not tricking anybody, snake. We know you're there. We're waiting for you. You're dying now. Fuck you, snake. Fuck you to death. Okay. Success! We did it! Sorry, I just realized that I'm getting gradually quieter over time. It's not intentional. It's just I'm thinking, and I'm gradually slow- Ooh. How many jars is that? That's 5 jars. Break them anyway because they're in my way. It's behind those jars, huh? Any snakes? Because usually there's snakes. So that might be a chamber. We'll check that out in a moment. Just finish exploring first. Keep looking for buttons. Man, if I miss a button, the subscriber is definitely going to be noticing it before me. Oh, right, this guy's starving. How did I... I can't believe I zoned out and didn't feed him. No, I just used a healing potion for no reason. Fuck it. Okay. There goes a healing potion. They're not that expensive to get though. I'm not about to reload a save just for a healing potion. It is a bit of a bummer though that you can so easily misclick and lose that kind of thing. Where am I now? I'm just going back the way I came now, so I guess I'll go pull that chain and see if I can find Mr. Hedonist. Anyone here to kill me? Not yet. Not yet. Okay. But I'm ready for you guys. Oh, it's getting dark in here. Spooky, 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 spooky. Yes! Okay. Makes me uncomfortable when it gets really dark like that. So we have to... Oh, okay. We have to open this up by throwing something. Wacha! That did not open it. Okay. Well, pressure plate is pressed, regardless. Is there another pressure plate over here? There is. Okay. Chkow! There we go. Just throw it across for the pressure plate. Oh, it's only 5 jars. Still only 5. Okay, nothing behind them? No secret? Oh well. Seeing how simple these puzzles are, they definitely want you to go to the bog at the beginning of the game, and then come here after that because you unlock the entrance. And then it's just so easy to progress at that point, isn't it? What do we have here? A dead end? Is it a dead end? Have I been to the other side before? I have not been to the other side before. And this gate still closed? Oh. Oh, I don't trust this at all. Definitely quick saving. Because I think I can put something on there from here, but it might collapse my platform, because we've already established that if you press a pressure plate next to one of these things, it closes it. It did not drop me. Okay. So this gate's probably open now. Yes, it is. Okie dokie. I was very ready to get dropped, because I think I've seen them drop you before. Oh. Okay, so that opened that one and closed this one. So if I pick it up... Can't pick it up from here. It's irritating. Okay, so... I can't pick it up from... Oh, right. I can't pick it up from here, but I can put another one down. Walk around. Pick this one up. Put that in my inventory. And then pick this one up. And put it in my inventory. There we go. That was an easy puzzle. And now I'm locked in. So if anything bad happens, I'm in trouble. So that's a good idea to... That's a good time to quick save in case something really bad happens. But I doubt it. So far, things have been pretty easy. Oh, a key. Okay. That might be... Yep, tomb key. We're probably gonna get attacked right now, by the way. Oh, did not close behind me. Probably gonna be enemies in the next room, though. So we have a... What's here? Oh, 4 cannonballs. One of these days, I'm gonna actually use the hand cannon, hopefully. Because I've been ignoring it so far, but I'm collecting quite the number of cannonballs. It would help if I ever knew in advance when a boss fight was coming, because I would totally use the hand cannon against a boss fight on purpose, but mostly the boss fights have been surprises. So I guess that's it. It just looped around. There wasn't even an enemy that attacked me. I just backtracked a bit to fill in the map. So the map is full, and that's it. Okay, so let's go use the second key, and we'll see how much is left. I wonder if we're about to finish the pyramid, or... Yep, I can't... Oh, right. Teleport is just how this works. Okie dokie. Alright, so let's use the second key. I don't know how much of this dungeon to expect. Like, is it going to be over in a moment here? I don't know. So these are the ones that drop. Okay, so poison dart. Gonna have to use them again, right? So throw the poison dart. Ka-ching! Okay. Careful. I assume if I press all these buttons, something's going to happen. Or something. Or maybe when I press these, some different things are happening outside. I don't know. I don't know. I don't have any more darts to put here. I have food, but food is useful for me. So did they give me anything? They give me a torch. Put the torch on the platform. And I'll put one of my extra torches down. There we go. That seems like it may have been good to do. Yeah, all the buttons are pressed. Let's do a quick scan for secrets really quick. Because I wasn't very thorough. No buttons. Oh. Good thing I checked, huh? I might have to recheck the other chamber. I don't remember if I was thorough before. What did I do? I assume a wall opened somewhere, right? There's weird stuff coming out from behind this wall. I don't know what to make of that. I pressed the button, right? I heard the sound happen, so I'm pretty sure I pressed it. I think something's happening behind that wall. Hello? Oh, it's just the teleporter bleeding through the wall. So I can walk forward now. But what did that secret do? Let's backtrack a little bit and see if the next room back has something in it now. Were these open before? Oh yeah, these were always open. Okay, I remember these. Did nothing change? I think nothing changed. Here's a question. Is it because I only pressed one button? Let's check. This is the... It's the Highborn side, right? So I'll do a quick scan and see if there's also a button here. Maybe I have to press a button on both sides? And that's the secret? Because I don't think I pressed a button here. But there may have just not... Oh! Hello. Anything else here? Nope. Okay. So pressing the button on the other chamber opened something up in this chamber. The Mirror Tegelmoost. Okay. What do you do? Protection plus 8, resist all plus 5. So it's just the helm component of the mirror set. So now we have at least three pieces of the mirror set, which is a set that, it's probably pretty good light armor. So if this guy, if my ranged guy in the back row ever gets the ability to use light armor, he might wear that stuff, because elemental protection would be handy. He already has elemental protection, though. Yeah, so no, it's not even useful for him, because he has 100% resistance to cold and poison, and about 50 to fire and shock, so not even he needs that kind of resistance. Weird. So yeah, I'll probably just never use that set, but it's cool to collect it. Well, without much further ado, let's finally move forward in this chaotic and crazy world. So we have buttons to press. Huh. We have buttons in weird places. And I can't open the door, it looks like, until I press them. Question is, what do they do? Definitely time for a quick save. I assume I press the button and it changes what buttons. What happened? Something happened when I pressed the button? I don't know. Oh. Hey, pressing the button. Okay. Pressing the two buttons open the two gates. I have to press all four buttons, though, to open all four gates. And they all look mandatory. So, let's see here. I assume the pressure plates in the other room affect the pressure plates in here, right? That seems like a reasonable assumption to make. So, right now there's two perfect four patterns. Oh! The two perfectly correlate with the other room. So, which room is which is the question. We'll have to experiment really quick. So I'm gonna go into this left room. I'm gonna take this thing off the floor. Now let's see which room changed. This one did. A weird part of it changed too, huh? Yeah. So closed, open, closed. Is it the opposite? No, it's not the opposite. It's rotated. What does it look like in there? Can't even look in there to see. I don't know. Well, I suppose one thing I can do is I can just sort of move some shit around a bit. And even if I don't understand what's going on, it'll probably make some progress, right? So let's see what it looks like now. I moved it around. This button's exposed. Is that the button I need? That button opened something up. Oh, are the gates closing back up back there? I think the gates are closing back up. Do I have to be fast about this? There might be a time limit. So let's look at every button really quick. So 1, 2, 3, 4. Huh. This is a little awkward. Okay. So I want the center. This one has to be open because I need to be able to walk in. So that's good. And left can be open. No, the left corner has to be closed. So the front left corner has to be closed. Right center has to be closed. Okay. So position in the middle. So this has to be closed, which is important because that's how I walk in and out of this chamber anyway. And that has to be closed over there. And that has to be closed because that's how I walk into the other room, okay? Huh. Figure this out. So when I pick this up, it'll open, right? And I'll be screwed, so I need something on here. I'm pretty sure. But not necessarily over here, do I? I'm trying to figure out a plan here. Let's take a look at how this works out. So now I can move forward. I have access to that button, and I have access to that button, so I can go click, click. It gives me access to both buttons. There we go. But now I need access to the next two buttons and a way to walk forward. So those ones are also center right and front left, right? Front left has a button. God, I wish it wasn't so dark over there. Okay. That's frustrating. Let's see. We're closed here, okay. I'm gonna shoot fireballs to get a better look over there. Okay, back left. So back, left, center, right, all over again. But the entrance changes, because the entrance is not going to be center. The entrance is going to be either on the left or the right. So ideally, this entrance is going to be on the right, because I need to get to that button over there anyway. I'll figure it out. Okay. I'll figure this out. So this has to be closed. That has to be closed diagonally. So to close that, I need to take this button off for sure. Ta-da! There we go. Problem solved there. So that's closed, that's closed, but that also has to be closed. Let's fix that. Oh! That has to be closed. There we go. So let's take this one off. I think I may have just yeah, let's check. I think I might have just solved it altogether. Oh yeah! All the sides are closed. We're set. Okay. Now the whole thing is just to press some buttons really quick. And not accidentally strafe off of a ledge, which is entirely possible, by the way. Because I might be stupid.
Oh. Oh! I've realized a fatal flaw. Which is that I can't fucking walk forward. Shit.
So let's revisit how we did this last chamber, because I'd also need to be able to move forward.
Son of a bitch.
I might have to switch. Okay, I might have to just switch which side I'm walking in on, maybe. So facing this way, this one has to be closed, absolutely. This one has to be closed. That one has to be closed. How do I... Huh. So this one has to be closed. And that one has to be closed. This one can be open, though. So what if I... Okay, here's an idea. Throw something over there. Clang! There we go. So I can walk up at this side. I can walk in on this side, come here, through the middle, and I can go over here and step there. See, I'm gonna do this. Which should, there we go. I should make the corner open. So I should be set now. I'm set now, okay, I have a clear path to everything including the exit. So, it's just do some very careful walking, or I don't kill myself. Or, I don't know if it kills you, but it'll walk you off the ledge at least. Ta-da! Mission motherfucking accomplished. There we go. Hey. There we go. So what's my reward? We get fucking bug food. A pole axe is probably another reach weapon. Heavy two-handed weapon. 13 to 39 strength. Requires heavy weapons too. Cleave. Okay. Shitty weapon. As to be expected, everything here is a downgrade. But I'll hold on to it just because it's a cool, unique weapon. So it'll... be more stuff to decorate the hub with, I suppose. I'll show you guys that sometime, because I'm gradually picking up my various stashes and taking items back to the hub. Oh, no! This looks like a second floor. So, this pyramid's definitely going to be longer than I expected. Okay, Pyramid of Umas. Time to go to the second floor, but since it's a pyramid, I assume every floor is going to get smaller, right? Gonna quick save. Every floor is gonna get smaller. I don't know how many floors there will be, but if I get the feeling that the top floor might have a boss fight. That just seems like a natural... conclusion of how to progress this area. So, welcome to the next floor of the pyramid of pointiness and hiccups, apparently. What am I gonna find around here? Bo is starving. Oh no. Maybe you should eat some of that food you're carrying around all the time. Okay, what's this say? The Tomb of Offerings. Okay, let's go ahead and mark that. Tomb of Offerings. Ta-da. I am a genius, because I know how to write. Tomb of Sacrifice. Uh-oh. That's less encouraging. I can't wait for when I have to kill things with it. Okay. Well, I'm getting a little worn out, because I've been recording for a little while, but thanks for watching, guys, for sure. We're going to check out this whole next floor with the two different tombs, and who knows what else is up here next time. I'm going to take a break. Thanks for watching.